Warm greetings, dear students. In this video session, I am going to discuss the nature of antibodies, their structure and their different properties in detail. I am Dr. G. Hema, Faculty of Biotechnology at the Maharani Science College for Women, Bengaluru. In the previous session, we had discussed the different properties of antigens, the factors influencing the strength of an immune response based in terms of the properties of antigens as well as the recipient biological system. We also discussed the different types of immune responses mediated by B cells and T cells and also the types of antigen processing. So in the current session, we are going to learn the different characteristic features of antibodies. Antibodies are large Y-shaped globular protein molecules found in the serum of individuals. Antibodies can exist as membrane-bound antibodies or secretory antibodies. That means that which are freely flowing in the body fluids and tissues fluids. Antibodies are responsible for conferring antigen specificity to the B cells. That means these are the structures through which the antigens are identified by the immune system mediated by the B cells. Interaction of antigens and antibodies which are complementary to each other causes proliferation of that specific B cell clones which later produce millions of similar or identical antibody molecules and secrete them into the body fluids. You should remember that an immune response is heterogeneous, that is, whenever a pathogen or antigen gains entry into the biological system and interacts with the immune system produces antibodies for all the epitopes presented by that antigen or the pathogen. As such, serum immunoglobulins or antibodies are always heterogeneous. For specific purposes and applications, we need to isolate and purify specific antibodies, or we can even produce specific unispecific antibodies by in vitro techniques. There were three different experiments which were very important in helping us to understand the structure of antibodies. Those were digestion of purified immunoglobulin fraction, specifically IgG molecule fraction, with pepsin, which resulted in the production of a single large peptide with a molecular weight of around 1 lakh daltons, and this possessed two antigen binding sites. When the same fraction was digested with pepain, then two smaller fragments which were of around 50,000 daltons in molecular weight were produced, and each of these had a single antigen binding site. Along with these two single antigen binding fragments, one heavier crystallizable fragment was also obtained. So digestion of purified IgG fraction with pepain results in three fragments, two with antigen binding ability and one which is crystallizable. So that crystallizable fragment was designated as FC, fragment crystallizable, and the two antigen binding fragments were designated as FAB, fragment antigen binding. Now when the same immunoglobulin IgG fraction was subjected to treatment with beta-mercaptopril, then four polypeptide chains, of which two are heavy in molecular weight and two are comparatively lighter in molecular weight, were obtained. So on combining the information obtained with all these experiments and the available information that antibodies are glycoproteins in nature, they are globular in their tertiary structure, and the results of the previous experiments, the structure of antibodies was proposed to be Y-shaped in overall appearance with four polypeptide chains, of which two are heavy in nature or larger in size and two are smaller or lighter in size was proposed. So this is an overview of the structure of an antibody molecule, specifically IgG. The understanding of antibody molecules was done in detail using the immunoglobulin G fraction of the serum. and later it was understood that more or less all the isotypes of antibodies possess similar structures. So each of this heavy chain has four domains as depicted here, and each of the lighter chains have two domains. The heavy chains and light chains are held together by disulfide bonds. Similarly, the two heavy chains are also connected by disulfide bonds. So when digested with pepain, there were two antigen binding fragments obtained, which are these two fragments. Each of these fragment has a molecular weight of around 50,000 Daltons. These two are the fragment FABs obtained by digestion with pepain. So pepain caused destruction of this particular linkage, thereby releasing three separate fragments. This was the crystallizable fragment obtained with pepain digestion. When pepsin was used to treat a similar fraction, then what was obtained was a fragment in which these two fragments were connected. So the molecular weight was a sum of these two individual fragments. So it was around 1 lakh Daltons, and it had two sites for binding the antigens. And this fragment crystallizable was lost as small molecules and was not recovered in the pepsin digestion of the immunoglobulin G fraction. So when beta mercaptoethanol was used to treat the IgG fraction, then beta mercaptoethanol resulted in four intact polypeptide chains because it denatures all the disulfide bonds. So based on all this information, the structure of antibody molecules was deciphered. So one light chain and one heavy chain are connected through disulfide bonds to form a heterodimer. Two such heterodimers are again connected by disulfide bonds to give rise to an antibody molecule. As such, the antibody molecule is a dimer of dimers. So there are two heterodimers forming one more larger dimer. In each peptide chain, there are repeating structural units which are homologous and are called domains. Each domain is formed of around 110 amino acids, and each of these domains is interconnected to the next domain by a loop of peptide chain comprising of around 60 amino acids. As such, the light chain has two domains and the heavy chain has four or five domains depending on the antibody isotype. So each antibody molecule has its N-terminal region and C-terminal region. So antigen binding occurs at the N-terminal region, and crystallizable nature is possessed by the C-terminal region of the antibodies. Glycosylation of the antibody molecule occurs in the C region. Fragment crystallizable contains the glycosylation moiety. The first domain or the first 110 amino acids form the variable region. So this is the first domain of the heavy chain and the light chain. Together, the VL and VH form the antigen binding site or the complementarity determining region. CDR stands for complementarity determining region. So this is responsible for identification and interaction of the antigen. The remaining three or four domains form the constant region of the antibody molecule. They are designated as CL and CH, constant region of the light chain and constant region of the heavy chain. Between these two regions, within the constant region, between the domains, a hinge region is present in some of the isotopes, specifically those where only four domains are present in the heavy chain. In antibodies which possess antibody isotypes which possess five domains, there is no hinge region. The extra domain or the additional domain functions as the hinge region. To have a look at the final details of antibody structure, the complementarity determining region is formed by juxtaposition spatial arrangement of one variable light chain domain and one variable heavy chain domain. We can see here one VH and one VL are spatially juxtaposed to give rise to the CDR or the variable region. Again, each CDR is divided into a hyper variable region and framework region. It is in this hyper variable region that the vast diversity of antibody molecules exist. Because of the variations in this region in the amino acid sequences, antibodies capable of recognizing millions of antigens can be produced by the body or the immune system. The framework region more or less has a conserved amino acid sequence compared to the hypervariable region. So, the variable region is important in antigen recognition and interaction, whereas the constant region also serves many other important functions of the immune system. The constant region domains increase the flexibility of the antibody molecule. By acting as a hinge region, they allow the antibody molecule to undergo flexibility. They allow the flexibility of bending or moving away from each other so that spatially they can comfortably bind to the antigen molecules present on the surface of pathogens or large antigens. The constant region differences. The differences in the amino acid sequences of the constant region give rise to the different antibody isotopes, and this is also responsible for increasing the antibody diversity. Different isotypes of antibodies possess different specific functions. So, looking at the three-dimensional structure of antibodies, so this is the three-dimensional representative picture of the structure of an antibody. We can see here that V-chain region domains are juxtaposed with each other, forming the crystallizable fragment. The functioning of antibody molecules is dependent on all the four levels of structural organization of a protein molecule. The primary structure being amino acid sequence, which is very important in generating antigen specific binding ability of the antibodies. So the primary structure, that is amino acid sequence, is very important in antigen recognition. The secondary structure of an antibody is a beta plated sheet, and the tertiary structure is globular in nature. And the quaternary structure of an antibody is generated by spatial arrangement of these four different polypeptide chains brought together by disulfide bonds, giving rise to the antigen binding sites of the antibody as well as the constant region domains, which serve several biological functions. It is said that glycosylation of the crystallizable fragment or the constant region is very important in enhancing the solubility of the antibody molecules. So, as such, they can be circulated throughout the body of the individual. So, in this session, we will also learn about different antibody mediated effector functions that are caused by the constant region briefly. Opsonization is one of the functions of an antibody molecule. So, an antibody molecule can bind to Fc receptors present on macrophages and neutrophils through the constant region. So, an antibody molecule interacts with the antigen on the microbes or pathogens through the N-terminal or the antigen binding region that is present in the variable end, and at the other end where the constant region is present, it can interact with the macrophages and the neutrophils, which are phagocytic in nature. As such, the antibody molecule helps to bring the pathogens in close contact with the phagocytic cells and guide these macrophages and neutrophils to phagocytose and destroy those pathogens and microbes. So that is meant by opsonization. Another important activity of the fragment crystallizable region is activation of the complement cascade. So complement proteins are a set of inactive proteins present in the serum, and only when activation occurs at the time of infection, then these complement proteins give rise to an enzymatic cascade which ultimately leads to destruction of that particular microbial pathogen. Another important function of antibodies mediated by the crystallizable or the constant region is antibody dependent cell mediated cytotoxicity. So this occurs when target cells like altered self cells and infected cells are recognized by antibodies and bound by antibodies through their antigen binding site, and the constant region of those antibodies gets to interact with the CD16 receptors present on the surface of natural killer cells. Then the natural killer cells get the signal that those target cells need to be destroyed. So this is called as antibody dependent cell mediated cytotoxicity. So in this case, the effector cells are natural killer cells and the destroyed cells are altered self cells and infected cells. Whereas in case of oxidization, the effector cells are generally macrophages and neutrophils, and the destroyed cells are the pathogen cells. And transcytosis, that is transport of antibody molecules across epithelial membranes and mucosal surfaces, is facilitated by the constant region or the crystallizable fragment. Transcytosis of antibody molecules is very important in protecting the mucosal surfaces like the retina, the nasal lining, the buccal cavity and all other mucosal surfaces which are the points of entry of pathogens. Also, transcytosis helps antibodies reach the newborn baby or the infant through the breast milk of the mother. And through these antibodies, it is that the fetus or the newborn baby gets protection from the external infectious agents. Then IgG also undergoes transcytosis and reaches the fetus and protects the fetus inside the mother's womb. So transcytosis also is facilitated by the crystallizable fragment or the constant region. These are all the important functions mediated by constant region domains. To summarize, we discussed the structure of antibody molecules, how the antigen binding specificity of antibodies is generated, and what are the functions of variable and constant regions. The variable region of an antibody molecule is important in identifying and binding to the complementary antigen, whereas constant region serves the different effector functions like opsonization and antibody dependent cytotoxicity. These are some very good references which will help you to thoroughly understand these concepts. Thank you.